Today we will discuss the fundamentals of geometry, okay, and we have selected the topics in such a manner that whatever topics that we will study today are from the syllabus of JRF, okay, part A of life science, okay. So once first we will go through the fundamentals of the geometries. We will discuss about rectangles, triangles, circles, how to calculate the parameter, how to calculate the area, okay. Then we will actually solve the problems, okay. And these problems are similar to the problems that come in the JRF exams, okay. So we start first with the basics, okay. So first we take up rectangle. First we take up rectangle. You know, this is a rectangle, okay, with one side A and the other side B, okay. Now normally in the exams, either you have to calculate a parameter or you have to calculate the area, okay. Or in some problems, after calculating the parameters, then some other step is to be taken, or after calculating the area, some other you have to go to another step. So this is very simple. Now what is the parameter of a rectangle? Okay. So parameter is 2a plus b, okay, and this is the parameter. And what is the area?
A into b.
Area is a into b. So this is very basic, and I know that all of you know this. Okay, now we move on to the second figure, geometric figure. Second, we come to a square. Okay, so square, all sides are equal. Okay, so what is the parameter of square? 4a. Okay, so perimeter is 4a, and area a square. Okay, so again this is very, the third one is we go to a triangle. The triangle, we have got three sides A, B, C and the height H. Okay. So what is the parameter of the triangle?
A plus B
plus C. A plus B plus C. Perimeter is and what is the area? Okay, half into h by b. Thik? This is right, you are right. Half b into h. Okay. Now, if we make a right angle triangle, right angle triangle.
The perimeter?
Perimeter.
H plus A plus B.
H plus A plus B. And the area A also remains?
Same.
Half. Yeah. Half H into B. Okay. Then we come to equilateral triangle. equilateral triangle, all sides are equal, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So, perimeter will be 3A. Perimeter is 3A. Area
half into
H into A, and also as all the three angles are equal, all the three angles are equal in equilateral triangle. Okay, all angles are of 60 degree. Okay, so the area can also be expressed as 3 by 4 a square. Okay. Here we will take at 60 degree, then we can calculate H in terms of A. H in terms of A. Okay. So you get the area is root 3 by 4 A square. Then we move to parallelogram. Yes, perimeter is 2a + b. Area is a into h. Area is a into h. Here. Yeah. Okay. The next figure is rhombus.
Perimeter.
Area is half d1 into d2.
Half d1 into
d2. Half d1 into d2. Okay.
Is there a way where we can replace
d1
or d2 in terms of a?
No, then you have to draw a perpendicular line depending upon the conditions given in the problem. Okay.
And how can, like, always we'll
once, get once the problem will come, we'll go to that issue.
Okay.
We have covered all type of problems so that none of the things are left out.
Okay.
Trapezium. As far as perimeter is concerned, it is sum of all sides. Okay.
Yeah.
So whatever values are given, that we have to take. Okay.
So
perimeter. Sum of all sides. And area.
Again, H in
half.
Half H into
H into A, A plus B. Half H into A plus B.
B.
Okay, so this is trapezium. Now we come to circle. With radius r.
2 pi
r. Radius r. Okay. Circumference. Perimeter, or sometimes we call it circumference also.
Yes.
Then we have area. What is area?
Pi r square.
Pi r square. Okay. So this is circle. Now we come to semicircle. Semicircle.
Pi r.
Yes, what is the perimeter?
Pi r.
Pi r.
Pi r.
Pi r.
Yeah.
Pi r plus d.
Okay.
Okay. So, this is pi r plus d.
D is the diameter.
Right.
Pi r.
Normally we make mistake in this place. Okay. Okay.
Pi r is half the
size. Pi r plus d or pi r plus 2 r. D is 2 r. Okay.
Okay. Now.
And what is the area? Area?
How 1 by 2 pi r square.
Half. Half pi r square. Okay. Suppose we have two circles. The smaller circle with radius r, the larger circle with radius r. And suppose we need to find out the area and the perimeter of the ring. The area or the perimeter of the
ring. Perimeter of the ring.
What is the perimeter?
Two pi. In bracket capital R minus small r.
Perimeter.
Yeah.
Of the ring.
Yeah. 2 pi in common, then we subtract the smaller r from the...
The perimeter of the ring would be the perimeter of the inner circle plus the perimeter of the outer circle.
It will be minus, no. Right?
Perimeter we are asking. I am not asking about the area. What do you...
Okay, yeah.
You got my point?
Yeah, yeah. So...
One small ring plus another big ring, okay? Understanding that?
Yes. Okay. So, it will be 2 pi capital R plus small r.
Correct. 2 pi R plus R.
Yes.
You got that point?
Yes.
Okay. And what is the area? What you are saying for the grading area?
Yeah. So, pi capital R square minus small r square.
Pi capital R square minus now we are talking about the sector of the circle, okay? This particular portion.
Okay. Yeah.
This is the radius R. What is the perimeter?
Twice R plus L.
Yes. Perimeter is 2R plus L. Where L is equal to
length of
theta upon 360 into two pi r.
That's complex.
But okay, as you practice, it will become
easier. Okay.
Now we come to area.
Okay.
So we need to remember the area of the circle pi r square into theta upon 360.
Okay.
Because it is for that portion only, no? We are finding out the area of the sector. Area of the sector.
Theta upon 360.
So this is length L, length B. This width is W. The pathway given in the rectangle. The pathway is given in the rectangle, crossing each other at the center.
Okay. So, we have to find out the area of the pathway. Okay. So, how do we go about it?
W is the width.
Width of the path.
W is the width.
Okay. See, if we take this particular path, what is the length?
L.
L. Width?
W.
W. So this is LW. Okay?
This is area.
No.
Okay, okay.
One of the steps. Okay, yeah. We are still going on.
Okay.
As far as this path is concerned.
Hmm.
Okay,
hmm.
If we take the path, the vertical path.
Okay, the length is B and the width is W.
B to W, okay.
Okay.
Okay. So this is, and now there is one common path. See, we have taken this entire path, okay. And we have taken this entire path. Now this particular path is has been repeated twice, so we have to take out this.
Okay.
So what is the area of that path?
Area.
Yeah. This. See, we have found out the area of this path.
Yeah.
We have found out the area of this path. Okay.
W square.
So this is W square. Okay.
Yeah.
So minus W square.
Okay.
Getting it?
Yes.
Okay. So if you take W as common, then this is L plus P
minus 1.
W.
Oh, minus W. Okay. This is the area that we are talking about.
Yes. Area of the
path.
Path. Internal path. Both the paths. Yes. Okay, so these are some of the basics that I thought one should know before we go to the actual problems. Okay.
There is no such perimeter in this case.
There would not be a perimeter. You have to add everything.
Okay.
And then whatever portions are repeated, that you have to subtract. That's all.
Okay.
Area was a little bit typical, so I focused on area only.
Okay.
Now we'll discuss two triangles. One is the right angle triangle. Normally, lot of problems of right angle triangle. Okay. Area we already know. Okay. But suppose in this case, this in the right angle triangle, when we have to find out the side. Okay. We have to use Pythagoras theorem. Okay. So in this case, the side B is given by B square is given by A square plus C square. Okay. This we should remember because almost all the problems of this general aptitude, wherever the triangle is, wherever the triangle is there in the problem, it is normally a right angle triangle. Okay, and we have to find out normally some of the sides or area or something like that. Okay.
Okay.
And another thing that we have to remember is the sum of the angles of a triangle is 180 degree.
Okay.
The sum of the angles of the triangle is 180 degree.
Yeah.
That we need to remember. Okay. So we start with the first problem. So you can look at the problem and then we'll proceed. Try to solve it. four points B A E L are on a straight line as shown. G is the point of the line so that the angle BAG is 120 degree and angle GEL is equal to 80 degree. If the reflex angle of at G is X, then what is the value of X? We have to find out the value of X.
X.
Angle of a straight line is 180 degree.
Yes, sir. Okay. I did something wrong.
360, 160, 20 degrees, 340 degrees. All of you got the answer is 340 degree?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. See, we know that the sum of the angles of the triangle is 180 degree. Okay. And a straight line also makes an angle of 180 degree. Okay. So, in this case, first we find out GAE, angle. GAE. Okay. Now this angle is given to us. GAB angle is given to us. Okay. And these lines make 180 degree. Okay, angle. So 180 degree minus 120 degree. Okay. So what you get is 60 degree. Okay. So this angle is 60 degree. Okay, now we have to find out this angle. Okay, so angle GEA, angle GEA. Okay, so this angle GEL is 80 degree. So again, we minus 80 degree from 180 degree. So what we get is 100 degree. Okay, so this is 100 degree. Okay. Now we know that the sum of the three angles of a triangle is 180 degree. So this is 60 degree, this is 100 degree. That means this is 20 degree. Okay. So these three sums up to 180 degree. Now the entire the angle of the circle is 360 degree. Out of that we know this is 20 degree. Okay. So the other part is 340 degree. Okay. So the angle X is equal to 360 degree minus 20 degree. So answer is 340 degree. Clear? Clear to everybody? Now we move on to the problem number 2. Four pieces of teak are placed in parallel position as shown in perpendicular to line M. Okay, all the four pieces W, X, Y and Z are perpendicular to line M. Okay. Piece W is 5 meter long, piece X is 3 meter long and is and its left side left end is 3 meter from M. And its left side is 3 meter from M. Okay. That means the starting point of X is 3 meter away from M. Similarly, piece Y is 5 meter long and is 2 meter from line M. Piece Z is 4 meter long and is 1.5 meter from M. Okay. A single cut perpendicular to the pieces of teak is made along the dotted line L. The total length of teak on each side of L is the same. Okay. What is the length in meters of the part of piece W to the left of the cut? Okay, so we have to find out the part of the piece W to the left of L. Okay, and what we have been given here? See, we have been given the length of all the four pieces. Okay, and we have also been given the distance of the left side. Okay, from M. Okay, and we have also been given the third data is that when it is cut, when all the four pieces are cut, okay, perpendicularly, the sum of the length on both the sides are same.
Same.
So how do we go about it? I'll try to draw the figure first. M. L. This is W. This is X. This is Y. And this is Z. Okay. What we are given is W is 5 meter long. Okay. Piece X is 3 meter long and its left hand is 3 meter from M. Okay. This is 5 meter long. This is 3 meter long and its left side is
3 meters.
3 meter. Okay. 3 meter from this place. Similarly for Y.
It's 5 meter long and 2 meters away from the
5 meter and 2 meters away from this place.
Yes.
And Z is 1.5 meter away, no?
Yes, sir.
And what is the length?
4 meters.
4 meters. So this data is available with us. Okay. And what we have to find out?
We have to find out the W. Length of the W left to the cut.
Length of the W left to the
cut.
Cut. This we have to find out.
Distance we have to find
D. Okay. This problem looks to be complicated, but this is a very simple problem.
Yes, sir. What is the length in meters? The total length of the tape on each side of L is same.
So how do we start?
First we'll find the we'll divide each X, Y, Z into the portions left. Like we'll determine the length of the portions that are left to the cut.
Okay. But we don't know what is the portion to the left of the cut or to the right of the cut.
But it says the total length of the teak on each side of L.
Total length when the pieces are cut, na?
Okay, okay.
See, for this is this much and this side is this much. When you add up all this thing on the left hand side and add up all this thing on the right hand side, they are equal.
Okay.
Not individually. Not individually. Okay. So first, let us assume that the distance
is D.
Is D. The W is D. Okay. D is the distance from M to L, okay, which is same as the left side cut of W, which we have to find out. Okay.
Yes.
Now, what other information that we have is that X, the starting point of X or the left side point of X, okay, would be for x, it would be, it is d minus 3 meters away from
the m.
This part. This part.
Yes, sir.
Barabar?
Yes, sir.
Similarly, for y, we have, it is d minus 2.
Yes.
And for z, it is
d minus 1.5.
D minus 1.5.
Now we can add up.
Okay. This we have.
Yes, sir.
And apart from this, we have been told that the sum of all the pieces, when it is cut, okay, it is same. Okay. So, if we take the length of the pieces, okay, so W is 5 plus 3
plus 5
plus 4. Okay. So, half of this is this side and half of this is that side. Okay. So, what it comes to?
17 by 2.
17 by 2. That is
8.5
meter. Is that okay?
Yes.
Clear? Now, D plus D minus 3 plus D minus 2 plus D minus 1.5, okay, is the part of the pieces on the left side. Is that okay? The sum on the left side.
Yes, sir.
Part of the pieces of the sum on the left side. Okay, so what we have is D plus D minus 3 plus D minus 2 plus D minus
1.5.
This is on the left side of the cut. And this is equal to
8.5.
Now, can we find out D?
Yes.
Find out. Let everybody get the answer for that. What is the answer?
3.7.
3.7. You are getting exactly 3.7? 3.75 is the answer. Okay, we move on to the next question. Is this clear to everybody?
Yes.
D is 3.75 meter.
Next.
The design shown in the figure is that of a circular clock face inscribed in a triangular base. AF and FC are equal. Find AB. We have to find out AB. A, B, C. This is F. D, A, D. Okay. This is 7 inch.
7.5.
And this is 7.5, no?
Yeah.
7.5 inch. Into 2 inch. Okay, this is the data given to us.
Yes.
And what we have to find out? You have to find out AB. Do you get some idea how do we find out AB?
Yes.
Please go ahead.
First, we can drop a perpendicular B to F, and since it is a right angle triangle,
correct,
we can find the, by Pythagoras theorem, we can find the height of H.
Okay.
And then similarly, we already have AF.
Correct.
We get the edge, and then we can find AB.
Okay. You can do that. Okay.
Yeah.
The other method is, yes, you go ahead with that. The other method is that from the same point, okay, if two lines are tangent to the circle, okay, then the lines are equal.
Okay.
Okay. So you can use that method also.
Okay.
Okay. So just
then it,
what the method what you said was also right.
But it's
and we try this method also. Means one of the method is known. Okay, you draw a perpendicular, okay, and then you find out H. Okay, in that, then there will be one problem. You don't have the measurement of BC to find out H.
Okay, that is just BE.
B, yeah, that is BE.
BE.
2 inches BE. Okay.
Okay.
So what method we will use here is when two lines are originating from the same point and are tangent to the circle, they are equal. Okay, so how do we go about this? We have to find out AB. So what all we can find out from this?
We can find out that DB is 2 inches.
DB is 2 inches.
And AF is 7.5 inches.
AF is 7.5 inches.
So AD is also 7.5.
AD is also 7.5 inches.
So that is 9.5 into
2. So AB is equal to AD
plus
DB, and this is equal to 7.5 plus 2. So your AB is equal to 9.5 inches. See, sometimes because we are not clear of the concept, we are not able to solve the problem. But once concepts are clear, some problems are very simple.
Yes.
And that can be solved immediately. Okay. Mm-hmm. And whatever this problem that we are solving, it has already come in the earlier paper of JRF.
Okay.
Next.
the rectangular pentagon has all sides and angles equal. If the shaded pentagon is enclosed in squares and triangles as shown, what is the size of angle X? Okay, we have to find out angle X.
X.
A regular pentagon has all sides and angles equal. It is already given, okay?
Mm.
I'll just draw the pentagon. I will not draw the other part. And then we will see how to play about it. So this is pentagon, okay?
Mm.
What we know is all angles are equal. A regular pentagon, all angles are equal. Okay. Now see, now what is the total angle inside the pentagon, no? Then only we'll be able to find out the five angles. There are five angles in this.
Mm.
So if you join this way, and suppose this. Now what we have?
Three triangles.
Three triangles. The sum of angle of one triangle is
180 degrees.
Here we have got three triangles.
Mm.
Three into 180. So this comes to?
5.
Yes.
540 degrees.
18 3 is 54.
Hmm.
Okay. Measure of one angle five angles are there?
Yes sir.
Total sum of total sum of angles inside that pentagon is 540.
Mm.
One, so we get one. How much that would be? 108 degrees.
Is this the answer?
No. See, this is 108 degree, okay?
Yeah.
Here it is. I'll take this. This is X. Is that okay?
Okay. Now there is something which is two perpendiculars when bisect each other, they have the same angle.
So this and this will have 90 degree.
Yeah.
Okay. And we know the angle of the circle is 360 degrees.
360
okay.
degrees.
So we have got four angles.
Hmm.
So X plus 90 plus 90 plus 108, okay, we have got four angles.
Mm.
Is equal to 360. 72 degree. X is equal to
72 degree.
How did we come to a conclusion that those two angles are 90 degrees? Because
see, this particular, if you extend this line, this will go this way.
Mm-hmm.
And when you take any two lines passing through the same point, okay, and it is a part of regular pentagon.
Okay.
Okay. So when they cross each other, they will pass at 90 degree only. Okay. Next, sir.
What is the total area?
12, 1 by 1 square from a rectangle as shown in the figure. What is the total area of the shaded region?
This is same like the pathway, no?
No, here you can make use of Pythagoras theorem and the area of the rectangle. See, you have got a rectangle, okay, with length and width already given to you.
Hmm.
What is the length?
12, 1 by 1, 2.
Each four. Square is 1 by 1. So length is 4.
4.
Width is?
3.
3. So you got the area of the rectangle?
Hmm.
Total area.
Hmm.
Okay. If you subtract the area of the triangle.
Okay.
From the area of the rectangle.
Hmm.
So you will get the area of the shaded region.
But
okay.
Then area.
Yes. This is your figure?
Yes.
This is 4. This is 3. So, length is equal to 4. Width is equal to 3.
Hmm.
Area of rectangle.
12 meters square.
Okay.
Hmm.
Now, what is the length of the base of the triangle?
1.
Mm-hmm. What is the height of the triangle? 4.
It can't be 4, right?
1, 2, 3, 4. See, if you draw.
Okay, that.
Height.
But, Take care.
Okay.
Mm.
4.
Mm. Height is 4 meter. Okay, Pythagoras.
No, you know the height. Area of triangle is half
pi r
base into
height.
Height. half, base is?
1.
Height is?
4.
So this comes to 2. So area of shaded region. Minus 2. Okay, so it's 10. Okay, I hope this is clear.
Won't we subtract like?
See, you do that way also. Okay, the answer will be same only. See, what you can do is, you first find out the area of this region.
Yeah.
You can find out the area of this region, add up, okay. Then also you'll get the same answer.
Okay. Now we just found out the area of the bigger region.
Area of the total rectangle and the area of the triangle. We have subtracted the area of the triangle from the area of the rectangle. So okay, we have got the area of
shaded region.
Okay. I hope this is clear. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you.
Gujarat.